almost about a decade ago, I performed an end-user training that really stuck out in my mind, and I want to share this experience with you. So this end-user training that I performed was in Chicago. It was for 2 days. Like I said, it was all for end-users. This training happened to be on the SharePoint platform, but honestly, it could have been on anything. The thing that I want you to focus on in the story is the experience that I had and what I learned from that. Right? So this was a training for about 30 people. They all sat in a room. I delivered the training. There's a lot of different things that I talked about to these end users, talked about lists and libraries and pages, security, web components, all the different things that you can manipulate, how you can use it for your job. And my focus, of course, was to get all this information into their heads so they can use it when they need it. When the training was over, after 2 days, the administrator who actually had hired me invited me to sit in a room that was on the side of this building, said, "Hey, we have this vacant room here. If you are willing to stay here another day, we'll pay you for it. And if there are any questions from anybody who you have trained, they'll come and ask you those questions," right? And had a beautiful view, by the way, from this room of Lake Michigan. Hard to turn this down because, well, I've already trained them on everything, obviously, right? That was my thought. I've trained them on everything, so they don't really need any additional information. I'll just be sitting here doing my work and getting paid for it. It's a win-win situation. So I agreed. If it's helpful to them, if it's helpful to me also, I'll go ahead and stay here. Okay, so I stayed. And what happened next, the very next day after this training, really, really surprised me. You know, there was actually a line out the door of people waiting to ask questions. And this is because they had specific things in their mind that they wanted to get done, which I had talked about the 2 days prior. But it's not like they'd forgotten it. It was very much about the knowledge that they had learned, the information that they had learned. They were having a hard time putting it into action. I'll give you an example. There was one lady who came to me and she said, "Well, Asif, thanks very much for the training. I know you talked about uploading pictures to something called a library of pictures or picture library. Could you show me how to do it? Could you help me with this thing? Because I don't know exactly how to do it." The point of the matter here was that she learned it, she got trained on it, but when it came time to actually doing it, it was difficult for her to remember the steps of how to do it. The how-to was very difficult to remember, and she wanted help, not training, but help on how to do that. That day, I realized after helping all those people that traditional training doesn't really work for end users. You know, traditional training of how we train developers, administrators, and others doesn't work for end users. Right after that experience, actually, I wrote an article called "Training End Users is a Waste of Time." A very bold article, I know. I wrote that, put it on my LinkedIn profile as an article. And I didn't know what to expect after this. But the outpouring of reactions and comments that I had on this thing was amazing. People validating that, you know what, that is very true. The actual act of training end users does not work. It only works when people want something. They don't really give a damn about managing permissions or metadata until they have a project that they need to do this on. Doing things up front and getting them trained up front doesn't help them remember all these things when they really need it. You need to teach it to them, or you need to help them at their moment of need. Lots of comments like that, which you can still go on my profile on LinkedIn. You can see all these comments there. So my realization at the end of the day, or my question that I asked myself, is do end users really want to be trained, or they want to be helped? And the answer that I came up with, in my humble opinion, is that when users come to me, when employees, when anybody comes to me who's a regular, typical end user, they are looking for help. They're looking for support. They want to get their job done. They don't necessarily want to get trained on something. They want me or us to who are supporting them to do it for them or helped them with it. And that's a very important distinction to keep in mind, that where it comes to helping end users, it is truly help that you want to provide, support that you want to provide, and not training, something that you would think that they're going to remember for a very long time. So hope this helps, for whatever it's worth.